what? Today is the very last Sunday of the year 2020. Isn't that crazy? A week from now, we're going to be in a whole new year, 2021. I know that really matters to you, doesn't it? Did you have a good Christmas? Ha ha ha. I can't wait to hear about what you got to do, and maybe you got a fun present. I hope you had a fantastic celebration and that you had some time to really remember that the true meaning of Christmas is all about Jesus's birthday. Last week we had a birthday party for Jesus here at church with our worship time. It was super fun. I'm sad for those of you who couldn't be here, but I hope that you did something at home this week to help celebrate Jesus's birthday. You know what we're gonna do today? You're darn right, the same kind of thing we do every Sunday. We're gonna sing about Jesus, we're gonna sing to Jesus, we're gonna learn a story from the Bible about an animal. Which animal? You'll have to find out. So for now, stand up, stretch up really tall. Ugh. All right, bend down, hit your toes. Ah, there you go, turn sideways. Roll your shoulders, ah, get a little loosened up. And let's start off singing about how every day we can praise Jesus. You gotta know your days in the week. You know those, right? What's the first one? Monday.
Monday is a day for singing. Tuesday is the day I dance. Wednesday is the day for playing. 'Cause every day I lift my hands singing. Every day
Wednesday.
Here we go.
Thursday.
Thursday is the day we're jumping. Friday is the day we spin around. Saturday we're so excited. 'Cause Sunday's when we're with our friends. Singing every day. I can praise Jesus every day. I can praise Jesus every day.
on Sundays to praise him together, because that is one of the ways that we grow closer to him, and he actually tells us to get together and study and pray and worship him. Isn't that cool? Okay, now we can't go any further without a little bit of a hug, handshake, high five.
Good morning!
It's a good morning! Wake up to a brand new day.
It's
a good morning. Step in on my way. Good morning! You give me strength, you give me just what I need.
Perfect. We've gotten our bodies loosened up. Now let's keep on going. We're gonna sing about how everybody should praise him. Yeah, that's you. That's me. Everybody. Mm-hmm. So let's do this again. Ready? Say,
Jesus loves me so, loves me so, loves me so.
Say it again.
Jesus loves me so, loves me so, loves me so. Jesus loves me so. He loves me so. He loves me so. Everybody praise him. Come on and sing and shout. Come on.
job. High five. Okay, so let me ask you this. How big is God? I mean, like, is he this big? Is he this big? Is he this big? I don't know. We just know he's a great big God. Yeah, he's so big we can't even imagine. So let's sing this next song called Great Big God. Help me out here, ready? Say,
our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God, and he holds us in his hand.
Our wildest imagination, and yet he loves us so much that he cares for us in the way that he holds us in his hands. What? Talk about sweet, right? All right, we're gonna sing one more song. It's a little bit slower, so now would be a good time for you to sit down on the floor or on a chair. Just remember that we're still wanting to sit our bodies upright and participate, because we're not done doing church, and we don't just watch church, we do church. So let's close out our worship time with a song that you're familiar with. It's called There Is None Like You. And in this song, who is you? Yeah, that's right, it's God. It's not you, it's not me, it's not your mom or dad, your brother, your sister. No, it's God. And the Bible teaches us that there is no other God but the one true God. But the truth is, there are people who will teach you differently. Yeah, there are people who will tell you that there's a bunch of different gods and you can believe in anyone you want to and it's all the same. That is not what God's word teaches. God's word teaches us that there is only one true God, and it does matter who you believe in. So we want to learn right from the start that there is none like God. He is the only one true God. We could search for all of eternity and we will never find another one true God, but the one true God. Ready, say, there is none like you.
There is none like you.
No one else.
No one else can touch my heart like you do.
Say, I can search.
Oh, I can search. for all eternity long, and find there is none like you. Sing it with me. There is none like you. And no one else, no one else can touch my heart like you do. And I could search for all eternity long, and find there is no like you. Oh, I could search for all eternity long, and find
search forever and ever, and we're never ever going to find another one true God, because there's only one. And this one true God we can learn about in the Bible, which is what we're getting ready to do. It's time for a Bible story. Okay, this morning I'm going to tell you a Bible story, which is from the Bible, right? And we know that the Bible is true. Everything written in the Bible is true. It's not made up. Even some of it sounds kind of crazy, like, what? That can't be true. No, it really is true. And this word is all from God. He used people to put all the words in the book, and now we can read it. And from this, we can understand more about God, about ourselves, and how we're supposed to live. So we're going to tell a Bible story. But one of the things that Jesus spent a lot of his time doing was teaching his disciples and other followers about God and about how to live their lives. And Jesus often used stories to teach people things. So we're gonna tell you a story that's from the Bible that Jesus told. Are you ready? Okay, question for you. Do you know what a shepherd is? We've talked about shepherds just recently with the Christmas story, because there were shepherds involved with Jesus' birth. So let's remember what a shepherd is. They take care of sheep. Bah, right? Is that what a sheep says? Bah. And the outside of their body is called the wool, right? And it's real soft. And they're usually white or gray or some variation. This one's gray, okay? And they can be different sizes. They can be big, like this. Hello, children, I'm a sheep. Bah. Isn't he cute? Well, a shepherd's job is to take care of sheep. Now, something you might not know is that sheep aren't really the smartest animals in the world. So the shepherd has to do a lot to take care of them. They help them find places to eat, help them find water. They put them away in pens or fences at nighttime. They protect them from wolves and other animals that want to come after them. And you know what? Like how I told you sheep aren't the smartest animals? Well, here's the thing, is that sometimes sheep wander off. Yeah. Have you ever maybe been like in the store or somewhere in the public with your mom and dad, and you got distracted or maybe saw something you wanted to see, and instead of staying there together with your mom and dad where you're supposed to be, you kind of wandered off down a different aisle, or you went somewhere away from them? Yeah, well, guess what? Sheep do that, okay? They wander away from all the other sheep and the shepherd who's taking care of them. And when that happens, the shepherd has to do something. The shepherd has to go find the sheep and bring it back to be together with all the rest of them, where he can protect them and take care of them all together. Now, Jesus told a story in the New Testament, which is the second half of the Bible. There were some people who were asking him some questions, and the way that Jesus explained something was to use this story about a shepherd and his sheep. So there was a shepherd, and he had 100 sheep. Whew, that's a lot of sheep, isn't it? Do you have 100 of anything? Maybe you have 100 Legos or 100 pairs of socks or 100 balls or 100, I don't know, crackers? You probably have 100 goldfish crackers, don't you? Well, 100 sheep is a lot of sheep. Let's pretend like these blue cups are sheep.
Whoa!
That is 100 of them. Yeah, I counted 3 times to make sure. Do you know how to count to 100? It's kind of hard, isn't it? So, we're gonna pretend like these are sheep. There's a lot of them. You can't even really see them all the way, can you? See? They're even kind of behind me all the way back, and they're stacked on top of each other. Well, Jesus told the story about a shepherd who had 100 sheep, and he was taking care of them, doing what shepherds do, when one time one of the sheep wandered away. So we're going to pretend like this is the one who wandered away. So that sheep wandered away, and he wasn't with the rest of the sheep. Now, obviously, you saw me move that sheep, so you know that one of them was taken, but if you were just looking before and after, you probably wouldn't even notice that one of them is gone, right? Because there's so many of them, it's hard to keep straight that one of them was gone. Well, the shepherd knew that one of his sheep was gone. And so you know what he did? He left all 99 other sheep, because 100 minus 1 is 99. So he left the 99 sheep and he went and found the one missing sheep that had wandered off. And when he found him, you know what he did? He brought that sheep back to where he belonged with all the other sheep. Isn't that crazy? He left 99 sheep to go and find the one that was missing. I don't know if I would have done that. First of all, I would have had to have been paying such good attention that I realized just one sheep where they all look alike the same and they're all generally the same size. I would have had to have noticed that one of them wandered off. I don't know if I would have even noticed. And when I did notice, you know what? I have 99 other sheep to take care of. I can't go wandering off and find the one who ran away. That's just crazy. That would probably be what I would be thinking. But Jesus was telling this story about the shepherd and his sheep, and he told us the story because he wanted us to understand a little bit more about how God feels about us. Yeah, he tells the story and says that God is the same way. When he knows that just one of his people has strayed away, has wandered off, isn't where he needs to be, God wants to search after that one person and bring him back closer to him. God wants all of us to love him and to follow him and to live the way that he wants us to. And God wants to protect and take care of all of us. And so when even just one person who he loves goes wandering off, it's like a shepherd with a sheep that's wandered off. God goes after that one person to try and bring them back to where they belong. Isn't that crazy? Yeah. In the Bible, it actually refers to Jesus as the good shepherd, because it's another way for us to understand a little bit about God and Jesus, that they love and care for us so much that if we were like sheep and one of us wanders away, they're gonna go chasing after us and try to get us back to be close to them where we belong. That makes me so excited, because I know that God loves me so much that he would come after me when I need help. God will do that with you guys too. Isn't that crazy? He is a good shepherd and he wants us to be close to him. And when we wander off, he comes after us and finds us and brings us back to where we belong. Our Bible story today tells us a story that Jesus used to help people better understand just how much he and God love us. They will search after us and they want to protect us and care for us and keep us close to them. So let's take a minute right now and let's talk to God, okay? And tell him thank you for the story, but more importantly, thank you that he loves and cares for us so much that he comes after us when we wander away or we need help, okay? I'm gonna let you go first, and then here in a minute, I'll close this out, okay? So let's all get our eyes closed. Ready? Mark, set, go. Dear God, thank you so much for today. We're excited. We know this is the last Sunday of this year, and we want to take a minute right now just to talk to you. God, we talked about the shepherd and the sheep and how one sheep wandered off, and that shepherd realized it and went after him and brought him back. And God, that's kind of hard to understand a little bit of what that really means, but that helps us understand that you love and care for us so deeply, and that when we wander off or we're in trouble or we need help, you are right there ready to help us and ready to bring us back to where we belong. God, help us to follow you. Help us to stay close to you. Just like a sheep needs to stay close to the shepherd, help us to stay close to you by reading our Bibles and going to church and singing praise songs and doing things that help us learn more about you. We love you so much, Jesus. It's in your name that we pray. And all God's kids said, amen.